How is it going, guys, and welcome back to the Random Pick. This is a showdown series where I have to randomly generate two numbers, and whatever those numbers correspond to in the X and Y Pokedex, I have to use those Pokemon in an OU or Ubers team. Now, last episode we had some pretty interesting battles with the Kricketot Endeavor. But also it coincided with Hoopa Unbound being released onto Showdown, so that was interesting seeing Kricketot teams come up against Hoopa Unbound, but it was really good. I had a lot of fun and we actually won a couple of games, so that's pretty awesome. But yeah, let's generate our first Pokemon and see what we get here. We get 36. Now let's go into Serebii and have a look at 36. 36 is Clefable, I think. I think this is Clefable. Yes, this is Clefable. Now that's interesting because I've never actually used a Clefable. I've seen people use them, I know how they're used, but I've never used one myself. And I'm quite worried about how I'm supposed to use it, because whenever I come up against them, they always do a great job, but they're probably going to be one of those Pokemon that I see people use all the time that I can't use myself. I mean, it has a massive move pool, but the stats are not the greatest. It has good bulk on the special side, and its physical defense isn't bad, and it's got a decent special attack stat, but it's rather underwhelming overall. It's only got a base stat total of 483, but it's got three great abilities, so I'm interested to see what I can do with this thing. Now, let's go back onto here and generate our second Pokemon, which will be 87. So we're going with an old Gen 1 episode today. 87, and that is... Yes! Yes!
And they're not mermaids, they're dugongs!
They're dugongs! Yes! Okay, this is gonna be fun. We have Dugong and Clefable. This is interesting. This is very interesting. So, this is not going to go well. It's even worse than Clefable. It's got a worse base stat total. Oh, this is going to be interesting. It's got pretty much the same bulk, minus a bit of HP, plus a bit of defense, minus special attack, plus speed. Oh, this is going to be fun. We're using two kind of similar Pokemon with different types. But yeah, I will meet you guys when I've created a team. I will be back in a second and I will see you in a bit. Bye-bye. Okay, and we are back. And this is the team that I have created around the two Pokemon, which looks a little bit like this. We have, first off, we have Wiggle Room, the Clefable. We have Moonblast, Soft-Boiled, Defog, not Defog, sorry, Stealth Rock, and Hidden Power Ground. Hidden Power Ground is simply to hit Heatran for a bit of damage, because a lot of Heatrans decide to switch in on Clefable knowing that it can't really do anything to them. I had to do a little bit of research on Clefable because I really don't know how it's supposed to be used. It doesn't go with my playstyle at all. It's kind of alien to me, so I'm kind of interested to see how it's going to go. But yeah, I've given it's basically a standard Smogon set, this one is, because I had no idea what to use with it. This is going to be me learning how to use Clefable, because I don't know how to use it. But anyway, the next Pokemon we have is their Dugongs! The Dugong. And the moveset I've given this thing is Toxic, Protect, Perish, Song, and Whirlpool. Once again, this thing, pretty much the same set as the Marill that I had, with more HP and pretty much the same special defense. So this thing is gonna put in work because it's quite fast, and I think it can actually do something. The leftovers here pretty much are the one reason that this set is better than the Marill set. Yeah. The only thing that lets it down a bit is its typing. Instead of fairy water, it's ice water, which is kind of meh, but we'll see. I was considering putting Encore on it over Toxic, just in case something decided it wanted to try and set up, and I don't know. If I'm running Perish Song, I kind of want to run Encore as well as Protect and Whirlpool, so I'm gonna do that. We're gonna do this. We're gonna give it Encore instead, and that's just one little change. Now, the next Pokemon we have is Seven Way, the Unbound Hooper, and I've never used Unbound Hooper at all, but I have a feeling it's gonna be used in the same kind of mentality as Chiron Black, simply because it hits hard, it has bulk, not on the physical side, but on the special side. and it has good special. It has, like, both offenses are incredible. Both offenses are incredible. If you want to have a look at its EVs, I've given it these. 160 attack, 170 attack. That's incredible. I didn't even have to invest in special attack because I'm running fully physical. But I'm running a banned set here because I really want to see how hard this thing can actually hit. I am very curious. I haven't used this thing yet, and this is, again, me going to be learning how to use it and when to bring it in and stuff. I know that I've got to keep it away from bugs and physical moves, so any special attacker that I think I can take a hit from, because I've got HP investment, my special defense is like 298, which is incredible, and I feel like I could bring it in on certain Pokemon like Starmie, or like, I don't know, what else is there, like any kind of wall, to be fair, because it doesn't care about status, it's just here to hit hard and hit hard. I gave it Gunk Shot because fairies are a thing, and yeah, that's about it. Now the next Pokemon I have is Spoderman the Galvantula. Now, I don't know why I'm running this thing. I just think that it'd be a good idea to get a Sticky Web up at some point. So, yeah, if I can get a Sticky Web up, 7-Way can put in a lot more work because it will outspeed things. Tiny Wings will... Actually, no, we'll come on to Tiny Wings in a second, but this is a simple Sticky Web, Thunderbug, Buzz, Volt Switch. There we go, sorted. On to Tiny Wings, simple little Crobat set here, Defog, Toxic, U-Turn, Taunt. Yeah, I don't know how this thing's going to work in OU, but we'll see. And the final Pokemon we have here is Caramel Lovechild, the Mega Charizard X, with Dragon Dance, Dragon Claw, Flare Blitz, and Roost. I don't know why I'm running this thing either, but I thought that a Dragon Dance setup sweeper would be good if I can take out something that walls it. For example, if I take out a Heatran with Wiggle Room or Dewgongs, this thing can come in and, like, set up and win. So, it's one of those Pokemon that I can just do what I want with it, and I don't know. I just want to get into the battle now. I don't know what else I can explain. But yeah, let's get into the battle. Let's get into our first one, and let's do this. Let's see if we can actually find something, because for some reason, OU always plays up when I'm looking for battles on this. But not today. But like I said, we haven't came up against a Heatran today. We've got this typical OU with the addition of a Volcarona. Yay. This is a fairly common sort of team to be facing nowadays, I'd say, but hey ho, I think I want to lead off with the Dewgongs, because I'm going to keep saying that, but I think that I can trap something here and I can take something out off the bat, so I kind of want to do that. I kind of want to do that. Spoderman can actually put in a lot of work here. It can hit anything for a lot of damage, including the Ferrothorn. It'll still do about 40% with a Bug Buzz. It can take out the Slowbro, hit the Dragonite and Skarmory for really hard damage with Thunder and Volcarona. So, what do I do? What do I do? I think I want to lead with their Dewgongs, so we're going to do that. Right, you're going to lead off with a Dragonite. I'm just going to go straight for the Perish Song, as you probably substitute or something. You're probably just going to substitute or do something silly. But you got, yeah, Dragon Dance. There we go. You ain't doing nothing to me. Now, it's up to this thing whether it wants to attack me with an Outrage, which is probably coming. So, so the only reason I went for Perish Song there was because it's probably going to go for an Outrage or an Extreme. Okay, Extreme Speed. I'm going to Waterfall you then. Whirlpool, sorry, not Waterfall. I'm going to Whirlpool you here. And if you aren't gonna... Okay, Extreme Speed, this Dragonite's dead. Simple. All I have to do now is switch out, and it's dead. So there we go. Whirlpool. Dewgong's already put in work. And now we can switch in to Wiggle Room. I'd say Wiggle Room. But, yeah, Wiggle Room. It has to be Wiggle Room, because we have no Wiggle Room. Outrage. Predicted. Dead. Simple. Oh my lord, oh my lord, okay. See, Dewgong already putting in work. I don't know why he didn't go for Outrage there. He probably thought I was going to switch, but in comes the Slowbro. And yeah, I want to go into Spoderman, but I have a feeling it could be running. You know what, I kind of want to, I'm going to go into 7-Way. I'm going to go into 7-way, as it probably mega evolves. And I want to see how much I can hit this thing for. It's going to go for a Calm Mind. And I'm going to go straight for a Hyperspace Fury. Because I want to see how much a banded Hyperspace Fury does to this Mega Slowbro. Jesus! Okay! Oh my god! Oh. Considering that thing has like a base 180 defense, I did not expect that to kill ever in a million years. No way! Oh my god! Alright, okay. Now, the question is that, you know what, I kind of want to just let it go now. I'm just going to let it go. I'm fine with that. Because I didn't want to risk it getting up a Quiverdance there. Oh my god! Oh my days, that hit so hard! Ugh. I kind of want to go back into Dewgongs, though. Because if I go back into Dewgongs, now I can set up and sweep here. Yeah, I can set up and sweep here. So, what we're going to do is we're going to Mega Evolve on the first turn. And we're going to go for a Dragon Flare Blitz. Because that is the best... it has to be Flare Blitz right now. Let's do that. Even if it's running like Hidden Power Rock, I'm fine with that. Flare Blitz just completely decimates it. Jesus Christ, just take it straight out on the... Jesus. I think Charizard does actually have the same sort of... Actually, how did I outspeed it? Charizard's base speed... I don't know. I don't really care, to be honest, but... Hey-ho. What's this thing going to do to me? I think I want to just Flare Blitz again, but I don't want to get taken out. So, I'm going to go into... Spodumon. We're going to go into Spodumon. We're going to take a Stealth Rock or something, and... Now, we're just going to go straight for that powerful Volt Switch. Because I don't want to sticky web with this Bisharp around, and if it goes into... Ferrothorn, I can just go straight into Crobat and I can do things and some stuff, but yeah, we've pretty much won this game because if we have Charizard around and we can get rid of those rocks, then we're fine. So Volt Switch is going to take it down to its Sturdy. We're going to go, hopefully, into Tiny Wings. So yeah, we're going to go into Tiny Wings and it's probably going to Whirlwind us or Spikes or something, but I think I want a Brave Bird now. No, I don't have Brave Bird, do I? We're going to Defog instead. No, we're not. We're going to Taunt. We're going to Taunt this thing or the Ferrothorn that comes in. And it can't do anything to me. So we're going to Defog now. Because, yeah, if we Defog now, this thing is just going to hit us with like a Gyro Ball or Switch Out. And we can get rid of those Spikes and Stealth Rocks, all that nasty stuff. And yeah, this game's just going to drag. I should probably have... You see, now that I've got rid of the Oh my god, Power Whip, what are thou doing? Okay, let's go for a U-turn here. I don't mind taking the damage here. But now that I've got rid of the Sturdy, I can finish this off with Charizard. I can finish this off right here. It can't Thunder Wave me. The most it can do is a Gyro Ball or a Power Whip or an Explosion, and I doubt it's going to use that. Okay, Power Whip. You ain't doing nothing, but I kind of die here if I take it out. Because if I take it out... Ah, crap. You know what? I think I have to. I can finish this game off with Wiggle Room. And I still have their Dewgongs around. So I think I'm just going to Flare Blitz. Let it take me out with the Iron Barb, Rough Skin, Rocky Helmet. I'm fine with that. I just didn't want it around. And now we can go into Spodumon. All their Dewgongs. God, what do we do? Yeah, we needed to get rid of that Ferrothorn. Needed that thing gone because, yeah, reasons. Okay, Skarmory's here. We're just gonna Volt Switch. And Jesus, what do we do now? Do we go into their Dewgongs or do we go into Wiggle Room or. I think we're going to Wiggle Room. No, what do we do? Oh, yeah, Wiggle Room. Has to be Wiggle Room. We're just gonna have to deal with it. Just gonna have to deal with it. B-Sharp comes in. Ah, this thing could sweep me here. Oh, I live. Your life orb. The crit. We've won. Oh, I got so lucky there. Oh, my days. We got lucky. Probably gonna sucker punch us here, but I don't care. Tiny Wings, you take that sucker punch. Oh, you actually took it. Okay, and that's the first game won. Their Dewgong's actually put in a lot of work. I'm fine with this. I'm fine with this. But let's go. Let's have another match and see what we can do. That Hooper. Jesus. Banded Hyperspace Fury does. Oh my lord. Right. Hooper again is going to put in the work right now. So we're going to lead off with it. We're going to lead off with it. And I don't care what you lead off with. You're going to lead off with a muck. Yeah. Try taking this. Let's see if you. Okay. Shadow Sneak does nothing. Hyperspace Fury gone. Just gone. Straight up out of my face. Out of my face. Just no. Just get out of my face. I wonder if it could even take out Ferrothorn. I want to try it. I really want to try it. So badly. I mean, I'm trying it. Oh, it does 65%. And it's going to take us. No, it's not. It's not going to take us out. Oh, if only we had like aromatherapy or something on this team. That would be so good. But we're going to go for another one as it's going to protect. And we're going to break through that because. Oh my god, I forgot. It breaks through defenses. This thing just. Oh! Why am I clicking the skip button on Showdown all the time? Why am I clicking the skip button? I don't know why. But this thing, I'm not even sure it can take me out unless it has a signal beam or something. I want to Tail Glow. You're risking it. You risked it and you paid off. All right. It risked it and it paid off. Fair play. Can't see anything about that. I could go into their Dewgongs and take a hit on the special side right now and keep Hooper around because Hooper kind of. What's your defense? You know what? I'm just going to stay in. Take the Scald. Take the Scald! Oh, it doesn't kill. It doesn't kill the Manaphy. But Jesus. Oh my god. I don't need Hooper anymore. Hooper has ripped through this team. It has ripped through. Banded Hooper took that plus three Scald so well. Oh my days. Oh my days, I'm at minus three. I don't know why he didn't just go into Dragonite. I don't know why he didn't just go into Dragonite and extreme speed me, but Jesus. Oh my days. We're just gonna go straight for a U-turn with Tiny Wings and get, just in case. I didn't want to take life orb damage here, so we're just gonna go straight for a U-turn and we're going into Spoderman. We're going into Spoderman. Jesus. Oh my god. Hooper. See, Hooper. Just Hooper. Now, if this is Scarfster, I'm in trouble. If this is Scarfster, like Scarf Cloyster, I'm in trouble. Could be Focus Sash, though. It's Focus Sash, I'm in trouble, too. Let's go for the Volt Switch. It's fine. Oh, it's not. I just outsped it anyway. Okay. And they forfeited. You know what? We have time for another one. We have time for another. I want to see. Okay. You have this sort of team with Mega Gallade, Tornadus. A lot of U-turn shenanigans could be going on here. So I need to be careful that I don't keep it in on Latios. Well, Latios is probably the only thing I could keep it in on at the moment, to be honest. So I think we're going to lead with their Dewgongs. And we're going to Whirlpool something. Actually, no, we can't Whirlpool it because there's a lot of U-turn. Actually, we can Whirlpool something. I don't know. We're going to. Oh, damn it. Wiggle room. Do we have the wiggle room? We don't have wiggle room. We are going to struggle to win this match. We have poor matchups against anything on the side. Okay. Whirlpool. No, Perish Song turn one. No, Encore turn one. Nope, U-turn straight off the bat and get a crit. Okay. Should have gone for Perish Song there, to be honest. Damn it. I expected a Stealth Rock, and that would have allowed me to Perish Trap something else. It's one of them. It doesn't matter now what he goes into, because he's going to have a free turn. But he has to think. He doesn't know that, so. He doesn't know what Dewgong can do. But that crit, that was. See, that would have done about 30%. Yeah, 30%. Would have left me on 70%, and then I would have been on. Yeah, Bladezilla, hello. Ugh. What do I do on you? What do I do on you? I think I gotta Perish Song it. Pursuit. Nope, Perish Song, mother fudger. You do that. Ah, Pursuit. Okay, Protect. Or Whirlpool. I think I'm gonna Whirlpool, you know. I'm gonna Whirlpool Lady Death the Gengar. He's now trapped. And now I'm kind of screwed. But I will go for another Protect. I will go for another Protect. Or do I? Oh, it's too late. It's too late. Shadow Ball. Alright. Okay. Alright, okay. I can't stay in anymore. So I have to switch out into something. And I don't really have anything to switch into. Because the only thing that could really take a hit from this Gengar is Dewgong. But it's going to die next turn. Now, the question is, what do I do? I think I have to go into Tiny Wings, but it doesn't have Bird Stab. And this thing outspeeds like my entire team, apart from Tiny Wings. See, if I switch out, does Whirlpool stay? Does Whirlpool? I don't think it does. I could go into Hooper, but I don't know how well Hooper would take the hit. And I don't know what item this thing has. It could be a Life Orb, which would do a lot of damage to me, so if that's the case, I want to go into Tiny Wings, because Tiny Wings can always U-turn out. So it's gone for the Sludge Bomb. Okay, that's fine, that's fine. It is Life Orb. I thought as much. If it's Life Orb, I can't really live a hit with Dewgong. Ah. I kind of just want to U-turn here. Go into... Oh, I don't have any priority on this team, and that's going to cause me problems. I think we're gonna have to go back into Dewgong here. I think we're gonna have to. I might have to sacrifice Dewgong, yeah, to get up. No, because then the Landorus is just gonna come in and halt that. This Gengar is causing me problems. Don't think we can win this game, but we'll see. I know I can live one hit uninvested. No, I can't. It's Life Orb. Oh, I was going to say I can live one uninvested hit. Not uninvested. I can live one hit, but I can't now. So, okay, okay, okay. I'm gonna taunt it. Whatever comes in. Yes, okay. That's fine. I'm fine with this. See if I've got Stone Edge. If it's got Stone Edge, I think I can live one. So I'm going to Toxic it. Yeah, I'm going to Toxic this thing. I think he doesn't know that I have Bird... he doesn't know that I don't have Bird Stab. Stone Edge. Oh, I can't live because it's an offensive Landorus. Jesus Christ. All right. Oh, this ain't good. This ain't good. This ain't good. This ain't good. Oh, it's not. It must be Scarf because it outsped me. Scarf Landorus. Scarf offensive Landorus. Ugh. Alright. Alright. Scarf offensive Landorus kind of shits on me, to be honest. Okay, okay, okay. I think Hooper can live one here. Hooper can live one, and I can just decimate something with a Hyperspace Fury. Apart from the Bisharp. Crap. That Bisharp runs through me. I think I'm just going to Hyperspace Fury anyway, because even if Bisharp does come in, it's taking a lot of damage from that, but it has Pursuit. Now, I don't want to risk a Pursuit, because I know it has it. I don't want to risk the Pursuit. Fuck, I don't think I can live a Pursuit. I can... Nah, I should have switched out. I should have... Oh. Damn it! Ugh! God, alright. Alright, 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 alright. No panic, no panic. Crap. Don't want to sticky web with this thing around, but I know Landorus is coming in a second. What item is this focus on? I'd love to have the Stealth Rocks up, to be honest. That might be the only way I can win, so I'm going to double out into Wiggle Room. And Landorus comes in. Yes, that's fine, that's fine. And we're gonna go for a stealth rock here, as this Scarf Landorus decides to mess me around. This is Scarf with Stealth Rock, it's got knockoff, alright. So that's not too bad. Stealth Rock's now up. We can Moonblast something. Bladezilla, that's dead. That's straight up dead. That's not living that. That's fine. Now he's got the free switch into Gengar. He's gonna... By taking something out, it's gonna lose a lot of HP. Because it's gonna take Stealth Rock damage on income, and then it's gonna take Life Orb damage after that, so... What do I do now? I don't know. I think we just gotta play reactively. If I'm gonna win, I need to get rid of that Landorus so I can set up on the rest of the team. Landorus is a big problem because Charizard here. Charizard can't do anything while it's around. I can probably do something against the... against the Tornadus, but that's about it. I need to let Tornadus take something out, and not with a U-turn. Okay, Gengar has come in as I thought it would. It's gonna go for the Sludge Bomb right now. I have nothing to take it. He knows this. So, I might just have to sacrifice Dewgong right now. Yeah, I think I have to sacrifice Dewgong and then Spodumon, because Spodumon... I don't know. Like I said, I could set up on the Gengar. I don't know if I can live a hit. I don't think I can, because it's... I'm bulky on the physical side once I've came in. Oh, do I need you anymore? You've got your rocks up. You can't really touch anyone else besides the... You completely wall the Latios and probably do something against Tornadus without Hurricane, but... 10%. It can kill everything I have left. I'm gonna have to try this. I'm gonna sacrifice Dewgong to a Sludge Bomb. Oh, it lived! No, it didn't, because of the poison. That is ridiculously unlucky. I mean, I have 1% left. God damn it, Dewgong. That was impressive. That was impressive. Very impressive. We're just gonna take the hit. That's fine, Dewgong. You've done your job. It's unlucky about the poison, but what can we do? We're gonna go into the now Caramel Love Child. And we're gonna evolve. We're gonna Mega Revolve, and we're gonna... What are we gonna do? We're gonna Dragon Claw. Probably gonna take out the Sludge Bomb. Yeah. Oh, crit! Oh my lord! I think that mattered. God damn it. I genuinely think that mattered. Damn it. Sticky Web. And it's gonna take us out with Sludge Bomb. I think that crit mattered. That's frustrating. That is very frustrating. Very, very, very frustrating. There's nothing I could have done there. Damn it. God damn it. Ugh. We're gonna softboard because I wanna... It's got Sludge Bomb! Come on! Are you just Sludge Bombing everything? Are you just putting Sludge Bomb on everything? My lord, my friend. My friend. Why? I don't see a point in that. Sludge Bomb everything. Hashtag Sludge Bomb everything. Bleh. Not even gonna take out the Tornadus. That's... Why would you put Sludge Bomb on a Tornadus? I genuinely would like to know why you put Sludge Bomb on a Tornadus. That's one of the more confusing things that I've ever seen. Sludge Bomb Tornadus. What does that hit? What does that really do? I'm trying to think. What does that actually do? I genuinely don't know what that would hit. Like probably only Clefable. like Clefable and that's about it. Because it can't touch Klefki. What else is there? Mega Altaria. It didn't do anything to Diancie. Oh my lord. Anyway, that's where we're going to leave this episode. I think today's episode has been a success, even though that last episode has left a bit of a sour... Like, that last battle has left a bit of a sour taste in my mouth. But it's still a good game anyway. Thank you for watching, guys. I hope you've enjoyed. If you have, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And I will see you in the next video I make. Bye-bye, guys. Whoop!